quick check-in to let you know how I'm doing. I just ran about 7 miles down a fairly muddy trail with poles and some shoes that I never imagined I would wear a few years ago, but they help a lot. Now here's why I think you're going to do better than I did. If we come and zoom into my knee, camera girl, and you look at my knee here, I don't have an ACL. Now, so you can see that my knee is very unstable. Now, I live in Canada, so our healthcare system is you get what you can get. So it would have been nice if they fixed my ACL, but can't cry over spilled milk. So I guess what I want to reassure you, for those of you that are having the surgery soon, and you're very concerned with the outcome and concerned with right after the surgery, don't worry. It's not that painful. The worst part about my recovery after surgery was I got cellulitis in this leg, so it swole up quite a bit, and it was extremely itchy, and I was extremely thankful for painkillers because of that. But I have a feeling that if I didn't get cellulitis, I probably wouldn't have needed painkillers. Now, why did I get cellulitis? Probably I was running around too much, doing too much on my feet, and I didn't rest enough right after the surgery because I'm an impatient person. I did the ice thing and everything, but it is what it is. For those of you who have had the surgery and you're in the midst of recovering, don't worry. I'm a physical therapist, and I really didn't have any physical therapy done on it in terms of anti-inflammatory machines. As far as exercises, I've kind of gone over what I've done. Definitely the humilis anterior raises. Really my program for the last 4 months to get me to where I am is cycling a couple hours twice a week, kettlebells, intense kettlebell training twice a week, very leg focused, and swimming a mile, two or three twice a week. And of course doing my 5 Tibetan rites every day, and doing my nightly stretch. That's basically what I've been doing, and I'm very thankful that I actually did get the surgery. And if you are getting the surgery, honestly, to me it's worth it. I couldn't even imagine walking 7 miles before I had the surgery. So I have no cartilage on the inside of my knee, and I don't have any. So my biggest takeaway for today is don't worry. Once you've recovered enough that you can weight bear, get this leg as strong as you can. For me, kettlebell cycling is a godsend. And I'm going to keep running, hopefully for the rest of my life, even if I have to use hiking tools and heavily cushioned runners. If you look at some of the world's best ultramarathoners, they use hiking poles. So if they can use them, I can too. So checking in from Hawaii. Peace. Good luck with your surgery.